So today I'm going to talk about the four keys to success. And you can apply these concepts not just to the gym and weightlifting, but also to almost anything else in life. The four keys are mindset, consistency, recovery, and tracking and quantifying your goals. Key number one, mindset. The proper mental attitude is crucial in order to be successful at anything in life. This includes body transformation and implementing a healthy, balanced lifestyle. So always have an attitude of, yes, I can. Don't get too down on yourself. Don't judge yourself too harshly. If you make a mistake, it's okay, because we're all humans. As long as you're moving forward and making baby steps and progress, it's gonna be okay. Also, write down your whys. Figure out why you're trying to accomplish these goals, because when you do encounter those tough times and you look back at your why, that'll help motivate you. Lastly, watch these motivational videos that I suggest, because when you watch them like first thing in the morning or right before the gym, you're gonna get pumped. It's almost impossible to not watch the videos and feel like you can conquer the world. So check out those links. Key number two, consistency. If you wanna fast track yourself to seeing physical changes, you need to make sure that you are consistent and dedicated, meaning that you get to the gym 3 to 4 times a week. If possible, 5. I know this might sound like a lot, but let me tell you this. When I was working my Wall Street job full time, I was also going for my MBA part time as well. So in order to get my workouts in, I would sneak off during my lunch break and go to the gym. This wasn't easy and it definitely wasn't fun, but you know what? I made it a priority because I knew that if I didn't work out, I would lose my muscles and I would get fat. So that's the reason why consistency is key. Let me give you an example. If you only go to the gym once a week, that means that every time you go, you're basically starting from scratch, and that's pretty much pointless to do. So, you know, your muscles will forget what you trained last time. So that's why you need to build on it every day and every week by being consistent. Here's one tip to stay motivated. Take before and after pictures today and date them and print it out and put it up on the wall. And then in like 2 weeks or 3 weeks, take another picture. And if you've been consistent, I guarantee you will see some noticeable results. And print that picture out and then put it up next to each other. That way when you look at yourself in the mirror or at the wall with your pictures, you'll see, holy shit, those changes are in 3 weeks. That means give me another month and you're gonna see more changes, and use that as motivation because that's a huge boost. Key number three, recovery. There are two main principles behind this. The first one is get 8 hours of sleep a night, and the second one is eat immediately after your workout, particularly the correct macronutrients. Without sleep, your body can't repair the damaged muscle tissue from your workouts. It lays out the foundation for all the biological processes, and all you have to do is lay there. It's super easy. So don't skip it and just make it a priority. Key number four, tracking and quantifying your progress. Whenever you create a goal in any aspect of your life, such as personal, business, or health, it's very important to be able to quantify and track it with specific information. For example, if you just have a goal and say, I want to lift heavier weights and look bigger, it's going to be hard to know when you hit that goal because you're not specific enough. And if you can't track your goal, you won't know if you're on your way to reaching a goal or even if you hit it. So what I would suggest is get specific. For example, I would reword that goal with, I want to increase my bench press from 100 pounds to 150 pounds in 3 months' time and gain 10 pounds of muscle mass. That way, you now have hard specific numbers to look at and compare and analyze. That way you'll know exactly when you hit that goal. So here's a tip. I create an Excel spreadsheet to keep track of your workouts, and you can download it from the sidebar. One last thing, and this is optional. If you can, try to find a friend or a work colleague who can go to the gym with you. There's two main benefits to this. The first one is accountability. When you have someone who's depending on you or you make a commitment to lift with, there's a lesser chance that you'll skip or bail out on your workouts. And this translates into consistency, which means you'll reach your goals faster. The second benefit is you'll have a spotter, and this is someone who can give you feedback on your technique and also someone who can help you lift heavier weights, because if you're by yourself, you know, it might be hard to get those 20, 30 pounds extra on that last rep. But if you have a spotter, they can help you achieve that goal. So try to find someone that you can lift with.